the Mega Millions drawing live tonight here on TV 23. Covering the High Plains with news, weather, and information from TV 23 studios in Sublette. This is High Plains Today.
Hi, everybody. You know what? It is Tuesday, October 13th, 2015. Hey, if you had yesterday off, sorry, you got to go back to work today. Columbus Day is over. Welcome to High Plains Today on TV 23. On today's show, we're going to be joined by the staff at the Baker Arts Center in Liberal. Toni, Diane, and Heather are all here to tell us about all kinds of stuff they got coming up. Well, let's take a look at some news around the area. A couple of things from the Santa Fe Trails Council of the Boy Scouts of America. Scout Night was held at the South Drive-In Theater in Dodge City October 10th. Several scouts and their families enjoyed camping out and a night under the stars watching movies at the drive-in. And a great day at the Cimarron River Cubmobile races. The boys burned rubber and had an awesome time at the Dalton Gang Hideout in Meade, where the races were held. For the first time in the 154-year history of the Kansas Supreme Court, the justices will be in Garden City. Wendell Wurst, Chief District Judge for the 25th Judicial District, said this visit was brought to the forefront by Justice Dan Biles and Chief Justice Lawton Nuss, who proposed the idea of coming to Finney County to the other justices. The justices will be in session at 6:30 p.m. tonight at the Garden City High School Auditorium. The justices will meet tomorrow morning for a few hours to discuss the cases they heard the previous night. Now, before heading back to Topeka later Wednesday, the justices will have a by-invitation-only breakfast with local officials and court personnel. Officials associated with the Metal Arc Dairy plant being constructed in Garden City shared more details about the plant and the products it will produce following a groundbreaking ceremony last Thursday. The product that will be produced at the Garden City plant is milk powder, which is milk that is dried and used as an ingredient in a variety of other products such as cheese powders, whey proteins, and infant formulas. Groundwork at the site is expected to begin soon, and the plant's estimated opening date is May 31st of 2017. The president of the Olive Garden restaurant chain has apologized to a Kansas City police officer after a restaurant employee asked the officer to leave because he was armed. Officer Michael Halsworth says he was waiting at an Independence Olive Garden to celebrate his birthday with his family on Sunday when he was on duty and in uniform. He says a restaurant employee asked him to leave because guns aren't allowed in the restaurant. He thought the employee was kidding at first, but she wasn't. Olive Garden spokesman Rich Jeffers told the Kansas City Star that Olive Garden president Dave George personally apologized to Halsworth later on Sunday. After seemingly bottoming out at just under $2.15 per gallon on September 29th, the Kansas average price for regular unleaded gasoline rose 12 consecutive days to October 10th, where it may have reached a peak at almost $2.36 per gallon. Now, the past 2 days have seen slight declines, and today it stands at $2.34 per gallon. Still, no longer is Kansas below the national average. Today at $2.31 per gallon, Kansas now ranks 26th amongst the state averages. And Kansas farmers are nearing the halfway point for planting of the 2016 winter wheat crop. The National Agricultural Statistics Service reported that 46% of the state's winter wheat crop has been seeded. The agency also provided its weekly snapshot of the progress of the fall harvest for other major crops in the state. About 62% of the corn in Kansas has now been cut, along with 25% of the sorghum and 15% of the soybeans. And finally, again this Friday, TV 23 KDGL will be giving away $200. Now, the jackpot went unclaimed last week. To enter, all you have to do is like the KDGL TV Facebook page and like or share the post of the contest with all your friends. Then, all you have to do is watch High Plains Today every Friday to see if your name is drawn. If your name is drawn, you have until Sunday at 11:59 p.m. to call the special 800 number that will be listed on your TV screen to claim your prize. Now, if the prize is not claimed by 11:59 p.m. Sunday, then it is added to the next prize. That will be $300 if it goes unclaimed. A list of the contest rules can be found at kdgltv.com. And that's a look at some of the stuff that's happening around. Stick around after the break. I'll be back with some weather.
You're watching High Plains Today on TV 23 with host Chris Jewell. TV23's internet service and 4G live streaming provided by United Wireless. Coverage you deserve. Service you expect. United Wireless.
You want to feel connected, informed, included, inspired. So when important things happen, we're here. Your local TV and radio broadcasters. America's number one source for news, weather, and information. On every screen in your life. We are broadcasters, always here for you, wherever here may be. Text TV to 52886. Tell Washington local stations matter.
When some people struggle with their mortgage payments, they become frozen, petrified, not knowing what to do. They do nothing. But the people who do something, the people who take action, are far more likely to get the most positive outcome. Making Home Affordable is a free government program. Call now to talk one-on-one with a housing expert about the options that are right for you. Real help, real answers, right now.
Now, the local weather forecast for the High Plains.
And welcome back as we look off to the northeast on the TV 23 Tower Cam. What a beautiful day out. It is really, really nice. Don't bother about this cobweb down here in the corner on the camera up there. It'll go away eventually. Let's take a look at the readings on the here at the station. 77 degrees, 28% humidity. That's pretty nice. Winds are out of the west-northwest at 8. Barometric pressure on the rise. Here's a look at the current temps around the region. Everybody's starting to warm up a little bit down the south. Perryton at 79, Liberal and Guymon at 75, Pratt at 75. Everybody in the 70s and upper 60s. Now, the dew points way down, except for Liberal, they're 43, Pratt at 28, everybody else in the 30s, so that's why our humidity is so low. Winds are pretty much out of the west, some at the out of the north, some out of the west, southwest, but everybody pretty much in the teens, not real bad out there. And we look at our current highs and lows. Last night as registered at the Garden City Municipal Airport, 77 degrees. Yesterday, 97, the high back in 1975. 50 degrees overnight, 24, the record back in 1977. No measurable precipitation in the bucket overnight. Looking at our forecast for today, 87 degrees. Winds are going to still be out of the northwest at about 10. That's going to be pretty nice out. 47 degrees tonight. You're going to get up tomorrow morning. You're probably going to want to put a coat on, sweatshirt, or something. Winds are going to be out of the north, northeast at 6. And then tomorrow, 81 degrees, east-northeast winds at 10. Tomorrow night, 52 degrees, clear skies, south-southeast winds at 9. As we look at the 7-day, you can see we've got some really nice summer-like temperatures until we get here to Friday, 63 degrees, a low of 42. Otherwise, we're going to start creeping back in up into the first part of next week. Lows are pretty much going to be in the 40s and 50s. That's a look at the weather. Markets are coming your way.
Hey! So, same time next week?
Well, of course.
Put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million. For free tips to help you save, go to
Feed the Pig.
This new family, and I don't know what it is about this one, but she can't seem to put down that toy all day long. Tap, 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 tap. Oh, and she even talks to it. She talks to that more than she talks to him. What's up, bro? Nice shirt. Who's she talking to? Her mom? She talks to her mom a lot.
Did you know kids who play outdoors have healthier lungs?
Totally.
I did. Did you know that boys that play with dolls make better husbands?
My son has lots of dolls. But did you know terry cloth diapers breathe better?
I did.
Mm-hmm. It's totally true.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you know that strollers have the right of way on the sidewalk?
Yes.
Yep, I did. Did you guys
did
know?
Did you know that kids who eat breakfast have higher GPAs?
Yeah, I know.
Okay. Yeah. That's actually what I was going to say.
Did you know babies should never touch silver? It's really bad for them.
I knew that.
Did you guys know that statistically friendly kids have more friends?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's obvious.
Did you know most people think they're using the right car seat for their kid, but they're not?
Parents who really know it all know for sure that their child is in the right seat at the right age and size. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to make sure your child is protected.
I'm putting that on my blog.
I just put it in mine.
Know what?
What?
Since I got adopted, I've learned a lot about these humans.
I know. I mean, check out these two. It's Flirt City over here.
Yeah, I noticed that. It looks like my human is definitely into your human.
Oh, look! I think she's getting his number.
Nice.
Your human's got some sweet moves.
Takes after his dog. Oh, look, they're doing that thing where they put their arms around each other.
She kicked up a leg. It's like in the movies.
That's awesome. Looks like we're gonna be hanging out a little bit more.
What was that? Did you see that fly crawling across the lens? Okay. Welcome back. I'm now joined by the ladies from the Baker Arts Center. This is Heather Williams right here. Toni Smith, Diane Marsh. We're all having a good time because they got a bunch of stuff coming up. You have your Elvis tribute is the first thing that's coming up, right?
Yes, we do. Elvis impersonator Joseph Hall will be here. He is doing a performance Friday evening at 7 o'clock and Saturday matinee at 2. They will be held at the Showcase Theater at the college.
Seward County Community College,
yes.
Area Technical School.
Yes, you are correct.
That's a mouthful,
sir.
Though.
It is. So it's nice to just say Showcase Theater.
I know, but I always have to say Seward County Community College Area Technical School because I'll get screwed up if I go SCCCATS. Anyway.
Oh, okay.
So.
You did
not so good, did
yeah,
you?
Yeah, you did it.
All right. So, all right. Now, is this guy, and this is a fundraiser for the Baker Arts Center, correct?
It's an
Maybe
event.
Kinda,
yes.
Oh, it's
yeah,
an event.
Kinda.
All
yeah.
right. All right. So what made you bring, now, and Diane's got a picture of this guy. Brian, if we can get over on camera. Yeah, there he is. And he kind of looks like Elvis.
Yeah,
well,
he's pretty cute.
He's an Elvis impersonator. Duh.
Well, he right. is. But.
There's a but.
There is all a right. but. You know, a lot of times when we see Elvis impersonators advertised or whatever, it's
yes.
the older Elvis of when, right before he passed. This guy is the young Elvis when he first started out. And he can really rock and roll and shake and he has a curl lip. I mean, he does
he
it all.
Yes,
he does that thing. There you go. Just like that.
A little bit. That's my
I can do that with my eyebrow, but I can't with my lip.
That's my only talent.
Yes.
Anyway.
We're really excited. We've been selling tickets. He is very vibrant. He has a stage in Branson that he does a lot of shows in. He actually called us because
okay,
he wanted to.
Okay, because that was my next question. How did you find this guy?
Well, they called us and wanted to know if they could do something in Liberal, Kansas. They have done a show in Dodge and got a huge response there, so they wanted to come out this way as well. So we said, yes, and ooh, yes. We would love to have you.
All right, so does he travel with a whole entourage, Diane, or what? I mean...
No, just a very small staff, his brother, and I don't know if he has a tech person that comes with him.
Mm-hmm. But
and
he does
it?
Have a band that comes with him sometimes. Now,
sometimes.
The band is not coming this time.
Oh, there's no band?
Well, not...
That's okay.
Yeah.
He'll have everything on track,
yes.
so
yes.
it'll still be okay.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
All right.
Huh. And he has a lot of props. He has a good stage props and things. So, we are just elated about this guy coming.
Well, I was reading, too, that this... In, what was it, season 3, he was on America's Got Talent, and he finished in the top 10?
Yes.
Heather, now if you're going to speak to me, you got to speak up. Don't be over there. She's not this shy.
She's just shaking her head.
You know, she's the administrative assistant for you guys. And she is very much more talkative than this when you call the Baker Arts and get you on the phone.
It's my job. I'm supposed to be friendly.
Okay. Well, this you need to be friendly here, too. So, but he does play a lot, and I mean, he does perform a lot in Branson as well as all around the country?
From my understanding and talking to his manager, yes, he has a stage that he performs on a lot of the times out in Branson, except when he's traveling.
Mm-hmm.
So I think they are based more in the Branson, Missouri area. And there again, you know, with them calling us, we just said, oh, come on, we would love to have you.
Wow, so, that's pretty impressive that he called you guys.
I know.
After being in Dodge City and went, I think I need to go to Liberal.
Yeah, wasn't that nice?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's kind of amazing. You guys didn't know you had such a reputation,
did
you?
We did not, but we like that reputation.
That's a good one to have.
It is.
So this is an event that you're going to have Friday night mm-hmm. and Saturday at the Showcase Theater at Seward County Community College. Mm-hmm. And it starts at 7 o'clock.
On Friday night,
On Friday night. And then his matinee on Saturday is going to be at... 2 o'clock?
Two. You
so if anybody wants to come, and now I'm assuming you still have tickets left.
Yes.
How much are tickets?
$25 for VIP.
All right. I was going to say anybody. $25 for VIP. Okay.
Yes.
What does a VIP ticket get
the
you?
The VIP, they get the first two rows in the center section
mm-hmm.
and the first five seats in the two rows on the side sections. So that all is encased of the stage.
Right.
So they are going to get those at a VIP ticket for $25. The general admission is $20. He is also going to do a meet and greet with everyone afterwards. So this is quite an event. We are just, like I said, excited.
So is he going to do a meet and greet after both shows?
Yes. Yeah.
Both shows, cool.
Yeah, that's what we all thought. Right.
So you can just kind of pretend you're meeting Elvis. Like you, thank you very much. Right
exactly.
there.
Exactly.
In Liberal,
yeah.
Kansas. Showcase Theater.
Exactly. He's back.
7 o'clock.
Elvis is here.
7 o'clock, 2 o'clock this weekend. All right, but this isn't the only thing you got coming up. And I know you're going to come back and talk to us in more detail because you have a biggie coming up, too. Not that this Elvis thing is not big, right?
He's pretty big.
All right. Your French Market. That's coming up. Because I think when everybody... thinks of Baker Arts in Liberal, they think of your French Market and the lights.
Night of Lights.
Night of Lights. You're supposed to help me with that, Heather. That's why I put you close to me, because you know all this stuff. But you have the Night of Lights and the French Market that's coming up, what, first part of November? Is that right?
French Market is always, no matter what.
It Rain, says shine, on the snow.
Exactly. It's the first weekend in November.
Heat, whatever. First exactly. weekend of November.
No matter what.
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter. So that is coming up quickly. And
yeah, you have less than a month.
Oh, yes, we do.
To get that done.
And so this last week, we started getting all of the tables set for the shops downstairs, all the tables set for the silent auction upstairs, and getting our bake shop ready. I mean, there, yeah, and we will be working from now until French Market.
All right,
almost
so
every
give me a quick on the French Market. What all goes on at the French Market? Diane, tell me.
We feed people.
Well, that's the important part.
We have a luncheon
okay.
in two seatings. This year we've changed the times a little bit. The first seating is 11:30, and the second one is 12:40. You have to call and have reservations for that. And it's this sit-down. You're served. We'll have servers. And it's the meal is just includes dessert and your drink and all the fixings, and we have I'm drawing a blank.
I do
we
that
have
a
all
lot.
Different
Don't
kinds.
Worry. I do that
we
a
have
lot.
All different kinds of shops and gift items in the lower level. The upstairs is our silent auction item that have been that you can bid on. Now there is a second change for French Market this year. We are opening up at 10 like we always have, but we are extending the time to 6 because we are only having silent auction on Saturday. That's the only day.
Oh, the
day,
one day. All
just
right.
the one
All
day right. for silent auction. So silent auction will end on Saturday at 4:30.
Okay, so you got a lot of stuff going on.
We do.
At the French Market and mm-hmm. Silent Market. And you brought some stuff, but you're going to come back and talk to us a bunch about Silent Market, right?
French Market, yes.
French Market, silent auction French Market.
There you go.
I'm sorry.
Have you had very much coffee
No,
today?
I have not had enough. That might be my problem. Anyway, so you guys are going to come back in a couple of weeks. Tell us all about French Market. Tell me how the Elvis guy does, too.
We will. Oh,
all
we
right?
will.
All
we
right. Because that is Friday night at 7, Seward County Community College Showcase Theater. Saturday afternoon, 2 o'clock, same place. $25 for a VIP ticket,
mm-hmm.
$20 for a general admission.
You,
all right. Diane Marsh, art director. Toni Smith, executive director. Heather Williams. She is the administrative assistant. You got to have one of those. Thanks for coming by today.
Thank you for having us. We appreciate it.
Yeah. We want you to come back because I want to know more about the food and the French Market. All right?
We will do so.
All right. Stick around. I'll be back without Heather, but I'll be back after this. Hi, I'm Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs at noon weekdays right here on TV 23. Hey, do you think you have an idea for something that would make a great segment? Somebody that would make a great interview? What about a community event that needs highlighting? Let us know here at the station. Email us news@kdgltv.com.
Feel connected, informed, included, inspired. So when important things happen, we're here. Your local TV and radio broadcasters. America's number one source for news, weather, and information on every screen in your life. We are broadcasters, always here for you, wherever here may be. Text TV to 52886. Tell Washington local stations matter.
So, I just moved in with this family, and it's embarrassing. The little one, he likes to go outside and crawl around in the giant litter box. I don't know what he's doing. I mean, I was born, and I knew how to use the litter box. Look at that. That's disgusting. Oh, poop already. You're making me nervous. Oh, okay, I can't look at this anymore. I really hope he grows out of this, for his sake.
Something I feel when I'm right here. Something that tells me that I'm oh, 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 oh. This is the place. Everybody here knows.
And welcome back. Hey, let's take a look at a little baseball action from yesterday. All eight teams were in play yesterday, from Carlos Correa to Jonas Cespedes. Baseball sluggers put on quite a show. There were 21 home runs yesterday, a record for one day in the postseason. Now, the last was a three-run shot by Howard Kendrick in the ninth inning for the Dodgers in their NL Division Series game against the Mets. They did lose, though. Correa hit two of Houston's four homers against Kansas City, and the Chicago Cubs hit a postseason record six home runs in their victory over the Cardinals. Cubs rookie Chris Bryan, who hit a two-run shot off Michael Wacha, found it hard to count all the home runs in that game. Three of Toronto's first eight batters homered in the ALDS win at Texas, and Cespedes highlighted New York's 13-7 win over the Dodgers by crushing a three-run shot. Now, the 61 runs scored Monday also set a postseason record. The previous postseason record for runs was in 1995, and that was only 51. So anyway, there was a lot going on. Hey, let's take a last look at our weather before we get out of here. Temperature 78 degrees, relative humidity is 26%. Winds are out of the northwest at 7. Relative humidity, or the barometric pressure, is on the rise. It's going to be 87 today, 81 tomorrow, 84. Look out for Friday. You're going to need a coat on Friday night, 63 degrees. Other than that, it's going to start warming back up. Go out and make it a great Tuesday, everybody. We'll see you back here tomorrow.
Keep up to date with the latest information from TV23 on our Facebook page, KDGL-TV.
Hi, Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs weekdays at noon right here on TV23. We talk about news, we talk about sports, we talk about weather, we're even going to talk entertainment. We'll have live guests right here on set with me. So, every day at noon, tune in, High Plains Today. We'll see you then.
Weekdays, here on TV23.
So, I'm kind of new here, but I've noticed a trend. My human does this funny thing where she goes around and gets all my toys, and then she hides them in that basket by the door. You know, but it's always the same basket, and it's always in the same place. And then she acts so surprised when I find them, but, you know, she's putting them in the same basket again. It's like, hello, that's where you put it last time. You were the worst at hide-and-go-seek.
So, same time next week?
Well, of course. Put away a few bucks, feel like a million bucks. For free tips to help you save, go to